Welcome to the TMC Newsroom. I'm Greg Galitzine. With me today is David Wasserman. David is the Executive Director of Business Development at Syniverse Technologies. David, welcome.
Hi. Thank you very much.
Thanks for joining us. So perhaps you can give us a little insight into what it is that Syniverse Technologies does.
All right. A little bit about Syniverse. We're a company. We're headquartered in Tampa, Florida. We have about 1,200 employees with operations around the world. We're a global organization. We have large operations not only in Tampa but outside of Frankfurt in Germany and in the China region in Hong Kong and Beijing, and as well as London. We're a New York Stock Exchange company. We have been around for over 20 years now, and it's not a company that a lot of the subscribers or end users have heard of, but we're very integral in mobile communications. A lot of the things that they do happen because of the infrastructure and back office things that we provide. Things like SS7 networks or data clearing and financial clearing. The messaging interoperability between SMS and MMS interworking between mobile operators. Number portability is a very big item that we're involved in. So those are the types of things that we do.
Okay, so you work behind the scenes with the operators in order to enable them to better serve their customers.
Yeah, we have about 650 operators as customers around the world. And they put a lot of faith in us to provide a lot of services for them that affect their bottom line directly.
Okay, so if I understand correctly, you have a new offering out called the Syniverse Next Advanced Messaging Hub, is that correct?
Yes. We recently launched Syniverse Next Advanced Messaging Hub. We're very excited about it. Our booth is branded around it. It's a solution for mobile instant messaging. So around the world today, there's wireless operators that have their own mobile instant messaging carrier community, where it's branded as their own name. And like where SMS was 10 years ago, where you could send an SMS to a buddy of yours, but it could only be in the network that you're in,
right,
with your wireless carrier. And then when gateways like Syniverse came along, it opened it up and created tremendous growth for SMS and MMS as well.
That's true.
So that's where mobile instant messaging is today. And what we're doing at Syniverse is we've created the Advanced Messaging Hub, which take all of these wireless operators around the world with their own communities and ones that are rolling out their own communities, integrating them together, providing a one place for them to connect for their subscribers to message with each other. It's a lot of things that go on there, like protocol interoperability.
Right.
There's several different IM protocols that we interoperate, make it very easy for the subscribers to communicate with other subscribers and not have to care what solution they have or what service they have.
So basically, you're enabling the operators to drive more revenue.
Yes.
And the end users are getting a better experience. They're able to now communicate with people across networks, sort of tearing down those walls.
Exactly. It's an ARPU increaser for the operators, and it's a way for a more robust and pleasant user experience for the end users. Like I said, they don't care what service their buddy uses. They just want to know that message is getting to them. And if their buddy doesn't happen to be an IM subscriber, their message will be delivered via IMS or MMS, SMS or MMS, whatever it takes.
Excellent. Okay.
Yeah.
So tell me a little bit about, I understand you're doing a trial with the Fixed Mobile Convergence Alliance, right?
Yes. The FMCA, or the Fixed Mobile Convergence Alliance, back in November, we started this trial, and we're wrapping up phase one now. The trial is with six of their operators, companies like NTT in Japan, Korea Telecom, Telecom Malaysia, KPN in the Netherlands, British Telecom, and Telecom South Africa. They're all participating in the trial, and it's a presence interoperability trial. The FMCA really feels that presence is a very powerful tool, and they want to be able to have the interexchange of presence from subscribers that happen to be on different networks. Like I said, we're wrapping up phase one of this trial. We've learned a lot from it. We know that there's several protocols, XMPP, IMPS, and SIP. And those can't talk directly to each other, and they need to be normalized through a hub and interworked. But we also discovered that SIP isn't always SIP.
Right.
One operator using SIP has a different interpretation or a different spin on the requirements,
right,
and another operator with SIP, they can't talk, but we're sitting in the middle normalizing that traffic.
Excellent. Well, David, thank you so much for coming down and sharing these insights with us. It's a pleasure speaking with you today.
Thank you very much for having me.
So we've been speaking with David Wasserman of Syniverse Technologies. I'm Greg Galitzine, and this is the TMC Newsroom.